Now, if the image of complexity classes that I just drew looked a bit complicated to you, I would have to say you haven't seen anything yet, because of course there are many, many more complexity classes out there. Basically, any type of machine and restriction that you can think of forms a complexity class. And a nice collection of these, if you're interested in that, is the Complexity Zoo, initiated by Scott Aronson, a theoretical computer scientist at the MIT. And here we have a nice formatting of this document as a PDF, but it's also a website. So Google the Complexity Zoo. It's really interesting to see. And as you can see here in the glossary, there are many, many, many more complexity classes than the ones that we talked about. So let's just see if we can find those that we already know. Here is FPT. This is the class of fixed parameter tractable problems. Here is P. Down here somewhere is NP. But you see, it's already difficult to find even those classes that we know because there's so many different other ones. And they have lots of different origins. So there's some classes that are related to approximation, some classes that are related to randomization, and many classes here are also related to special models of computation that we haven't had the time to cover in this course. So there's some models of computation that work with circuits, for example, or even more exotic models such as quantum computing. The bad news about all of these classes here, or all of the classes here in this document, is that we don't really know much about the relationships between them. We know some, but as you have seen with P versus NP, there's lots of open questions here. Which I think is also the good news for you. There's still lots and lots and lots of things to explore in computational complexity.